The topic of my presentation is a computational and experimental study of training localization processes in the postcritical stage of deformation. My name is Mikhail Tretyakov. I'm from Perm National Research Polytechnic University in Russia. I'm working in Perm National Research Polytechnic University in the department called Center of Experimental Mechanics. It's our staff. The Center of Experimental Mechanics equipped with different types of testing machines, for example, servo hydraulic, electromechanical, electrodynamic, and impact system, a big set of different types of extensometers, big set of accessorized special grips and fixture for different materials and structures, a digital image correlation system with different cameras, with different frame rates and resolutions, and two non-destruction testing system, its acoustic emission and infrared system. We are providing different types of test, for example, quasi-static test, cyclic test, dynamic impact test, and fracture toughness tests. We are working with different types of materials, for example, steel and alloys, composite materials, reinforcing elements of composite materials, different functional materials, and structural elements made of composite materials. We have a good practice in experimental study of postcritical behavior of materials. For example, it's different steels. It stage of deformation very important for understanding of processes which corresponds with the file of materials and structures. Here you can see full strain curve of steel of this one steel, and with elastic plastic and post-critical stage of deformation. And you can see that on this stage of deformation we can observe necking effect here and here, and it's a shape of specimen after file. And it's an open to question how we can which one type of interpretation we can use for using this for realizing computational with using of full diagram of material with post-critical stage of deformation. For example, we can use engineering stress, we can use true stress, and other cases. More information about experiment results of postcritical behavior of steel you can see you can find in this paper. Here you can see a shape of specimen, which is the way used, and here you can see some parameters of geometry, and this type of element were used, and here you can see dependence of some parameter versus number of elements. On this slide you can see chemical composition of this steel and some mechanical experimental characteristic of steel, for example Young modulus, yield stress, ultimate stress and other. In this work we used three different scheme of material properties. It's material with hardening, this one, material with hardening and ideal plasticity area, and material with hardening and softening area. And here you can see some examples of real strain curve of this steel. First case, it is a elastic plastic material with non-linear hardening. You can see here a scheme of material properties, and on this figure you can see calculated dependence of the axial force and displacement. As you can see on this slide, we have a practically linear dependence of relative maximum relative narrowing of the sample, and here you can see dependencies of maximum equivalent and average stress overall element and versus deformation. As you can see, in this case we haven't got any netting effect in the test part of specimen. Here you can see result of distribution of stress and distribution of strain for last loading step. In second case, we used elastic plastic material with a hardening area and ideal plasticity here. On this figure you can see calculated dependence of the axial load and displacement for the specimen. And here you can see stage of postcritical behavior of specimen. On this slide you can see curve of relative narrowing of the sample. You can see the, here different stage of behavior. Here results for dependence of maximum equivalent stress and average stress over all elements. And here you can see distribution of equivalent stress when the necking effect is occur. and here results of stress distribution and strain distribution for the practically last step of loading. Here you can see realization of necking effect. And the last case of material property, it is elastoplastic material with a section of hardening and section of softening. It's a postcritical behavior error. On this figure you can see calculated results. It's dependence of axial load and displacement. On this slide you can see the same results for this case of elastoplastic materials with hardening and softening area. Here you can see moment of loading when necking effect is occurs, and here you can see results of equivalent stress distribution and deformation distribution for the last step of loading. Here you can see realization of necking effect. On this slide you can see results for all schemes of material properties. It's a different colors and block curve, loading curve. It's the experiment results for the same steel. And in this table there are some results of heterogeneity of in these cases, and some information about some results about elongation and strain. Here you can see result comparison for of the shape of the sample after stretching here for different options for certain materials properties. It's a different schemes with only hardening and ideal plasticity, and hardening and postcritical behavior. You can see here no necking effect, and here we can observe realization of necking effect. And this figure, it's a shape of test part of real specimen after tension stress. So in the work, the formulation of problems for materials with different plasticity characteristics are considered. We used three different scheme of material properties with non-linear hardening, with hardening and ideal plasticity area, and with hardening and softening area. Numerical simulation of the deformation of a cylindrical specimen with different characteristic of plasticity and postcritical behavior under uniaxial tension under condition of necking effect is carried out, and the obtained numerical results are compared with experimental data. It is shown that it is possible to simulate the processes of loading samples under condition of the occurrence of strain localization in the form of a neck, and to obtain numerical solution of such problems with the construction of diagram of diagrams characterized by the presence of stage of postcritical behavior. Thank you for your attention.